Good morning, students. Welcome back to our chemistry class. I hope you all doing good by God's grace. Today we are going to concentrate on chapter 4, new chapter. Chapter name is matter. From the beginning, from the chapter 1, we are learning about matter. Matter which has mass and occupies space, that is known as an matter. Anything which has mass and occupying space is known as an matter. So everything around us which is made up of matter. Remember that the smallest particle of an matter is called as an atom. Atom came from the Greek word atomos, which means indivisible. It is indivisible. Atoms are indivisible. One. Examples of matter: anything that has mass and takes up space is called as an matter. For example, here I gave some example: glasses, computer, coffee, desk, chair, whatever it may be, a thing which occupies space, even as a person also a matter. Whatever it takes place space and has mass is known as an matter. So matter has mass and occupies space. Sometimes space occupies volume, space which means volume also occupying space, that is called as an volume. Mass means the amount of matter. For example, it may be kg, gram or kilogram. Volume means it may be in the liter, meter cube, likewise length, likewise. Okay, so matter has mass and occupies volume. Mass usually we will measure it in gram, kilogram. Volume is the amount of space of matter occupies, liter, meter cube, likewise, etc. So matter has mass and occupying volume, that is called as an matter. So how many states of matter we having here means we having three states of matter. Solid, liquid, gases. Even we have plasma, it is a fourth state, but we are going to concentrate only on these three states: solid, liquid and gas. So solid, we have rigid surface, a tight, there is no space. In the liquid, there we have little bit, enough space. In gaseous, we have more space. Water exists in all the three states. The only substance which exists in all the three states is water. In the form of ice, in the form of water, in the form of vapor. So when ice melts, it will be as a liquid. When water boils, it became as a gaseous state. Again, when the water condensed, cools, it becoming as a liquid state. Again, when the liquid is freezes, it becoming as a solid state. So only thing, as water is a only thing which exists in all the three states. Melting means solid to liquid. Boiling means liquid to gaseous. Gaseous means condensation means vapor to liquid. When the vapor state undergoes into a liquid state, that is called as a condensation. When the liquid turns into solid, when it freezes, it becoming as a solid one. These are the states of matter. So matter which is made up of molecule. Molecule which plays a very important role in the matter. Molecules. You can see the difference in the picture. Solid, liquid, gaseous. How the arrangements are there. how the arrangements are takes place in molecule. Solid, ice cube, apple, these are the example of solid. Characteristics of solid. How solids are characterized? What will be the characteristics of solid? Solids are hard. Solids are hard in nature. Solids are hard in nature. They are brittle and they are flexible. Easily it will be flexible, malleable, ductile, elasticity. All these characteristics we have concentrated on the last chapter also. So the general properties of solid. The intermolecular force and intermolecular space, which will play a very important role in the matter chapter. So what causes the difference in state? So there is a solid, liquid, gaseous, is there, right? So in solid, liquid, gaseous, what causes the difference? So what causes the difference means intermolecular force and as well as in intermolecular space. The force between, inter means between. So intermolecular force means the force acting between the two molecule, that is called as an intermolecular force. The space between the two molecules, that is called as an intermolecular space. So intermolecular force is otherwise called as in cohesion. So a space between the two molecules, that is called as an intermolecular space. A space between the force between the two molecules, that is called as an intermolecular force. Intermolecular force is otherwise called as an cohesion. So when we concentrate about the general properties or characteristics of an solid, a solid has an fixed shape and fixed volume. Solids have fixed shape and fixed volume. They have the definite size and shape. They occupy space and have mass. It has the mass also. We can hold them in our hands. Easily we can hold them in our hands. Solids are generally cannot be compressed. Easily we cannot compress because the property will, the solids are very hard in nature. They does not flow. That does not flow. A solid expand or contract very little on being heated or cooling. When you heat a solid, it will be little bit alone, it will expand or contract on heating and as well as in cooling also. So these are the properties of solid. Now we are going to concentrate on liquid. The intermolecular force in liquid is weaker than solid because there must be some gap. So when there is a gap, the force will be less when we are comparing with the solid. So the molecules are further apart, are not tightly held in their position. So characteristics of liquid: ability to flow. It can flow. In case of solid, it does not flow. Changes into gaseous state. Change into liquid also. So when we boils the liquid, which will be changes into gaseous state. In same way, when we cool, when we freezes, it will be turning into solid state. Characteristics of liquid. A liquid has no fixed shape. It will take the shape of the container. In case if you pour the milk in a glass, it will take the glass shape. If you pour a water in a water bottle, it will take the shape of the water bottle. So this is the characteristics of an liquid. Molecules can roll, molecules can glide and take the shape of the container. And then a liquid can be compressed only a small extent. Little bit alone we can able to compress it, not more than, and easily it is flow. A liquid can expand or contract more than a solid. Why? Because when a liquid is heated, the molecules are more vigorously, easily it will be moves here and there, so the space will be more. And then all the liquids do not mix with each other. So liquids does not mix with each other. Water mixes with milk. Honey and alcohol not with oil. Liquids which mix with each other are called as an miscible liquid. Liquid does not mix with each other, that is called as an immiscible. For example, water and milk are best example for the miscible liquid. Ink and water are best example for miscible liquid. In the case of immiscible, water and oil, the oil which used to float on the top of the water, they are called as an immiscible one. Now we are going to see about the general properties of gases. As you know that intermolecular space is much larger, the cohesive is much weaker in the gas than in solid and liquid, because the weaker the cohesion, the gas molecule can move much more freely than solid and liquid. Because of there is a more space, it will be easily move from one place to another. In fact, they can move about in all direction. Gases can move in all direction. Gases can also flow. Liquid and gases are called as in fluids. Liquids and gases are called as in fluids because of their ability to flow. So gases have neither definite volume or definite shape. Gases have neither a definite volume or definite shape. It has pressure, ability to spread or diffusion. So ability to spread in all the direction. What do you mean by diffusion? Gases freely mix with one another because the molecules of gas can easily occupy the large intermolecular space. Gases easily occupy the large intermolecular spaces of another gas. This phenomenon is known as a diffusion. So diffusion is nothing but occupying a large space with another gas, that is called as a diffusion. The fragments of perfume spreaded by the diffusion of its vapor through the air. So diffusion is nothing but molecules of a gas can easily occupy the large intermolecular spaces of another gas, that is called as an intermolecular force and as well as in diffusion. So here I gave one table regarding the properties of solid, liquid and gas. Solids: strong attraction between the particle. Liquid: moderate attraction between the particle. Gases have very weak attraction between the particles. Particles are very close with each other, tightly arranged, that is in the solid. Particles are still very close together but not neatly arranged in the case of liquid. By seeing the picture itself, you can able to understand it. Particles are much further away from each other. Particles are vibrate in place because of its rigidity. Tightly arranged, the particle which used to vibrate. Particles are able to slide past each other a little bit. In case of gas, the particles move around and bump into each other. Solids have definite shape and definite volume. Liquids have indefinite shape and definite volume. It will take the shape of the container. It have the definite volume. 1 liter, 2 liter, likewise, according to the volume, it will take place. Gases of indefinite shape and as well as an indefinite volume. Let us recollect what we have studied in this chapter, in this session. We have studied about matter, states of matter. How many states? 4 states we having, but we have concentrated only on 3, solid, liquid, gaseous. And states of water. Water is the only thing which exists in all the 3 states. Next, we have learned about molecule. In this molecule, we have studied about intermolecular force, intermolecular space. Characteristics of a solid, characteristics of a liquid. As well as in characteristics of gases. These are the things we have studied. Concentrate on this session. Thank you.